Up until now, every demo I've done has used one-way binding. That is, I'm updating the view from our component class. But now, we need to go the other way around. I want to update my component class from the view. And to do that, I'm going to use two-way binding. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to implement two-way binding in Angular. Roll the intro. In a previous video, I talked about one-way binding, essentially taking state from our class and displaying it in our UI. In this specific example, I have a message property and I'm setting its default value to default value. And then in the HTML, I'm using interpolation to display that message property. So if I look at our application, we can see that we have our view displayed and there is the value default value. Now, another scenario that we have besides going from class to UI is that we have to go from the UI to our class. Essentially, we're going to capture some type of input from our user in the UI, and we need to take that information and get it updated inside of our class. Now, there are a couple ways to do this. In another video, we saw event binding. In this example, I have an event binding hooked up to our keyup event. And when the keyup event occurs, I'm calling the onClick method and passing the value of that input. In that method, I'm taking that value and I am setting the message property, and using interpolation, we are updating the message in the UI via one-way binding, which is pretty cool. So if we run the application and I type my name, we can see that this works as expected. However, there is a better way. I want to use what's called a two-way binding. A two-way binding is not just from class to UI, but it's also UI to class. And to achieve UI binding in Angular, we're going to use a directive called ngModel. So let's go ahead and delete all this markup here, and I'm going to create the directive ngModel. The syntax for that is we're going to have an open bracket followed by an open parentheses. And of course, we close the parentheses and we close the bracket. Now, Angular likes to refer to this as banana in a box. To me, it looks more like the Eye of Sauron staring deep into your soul. So I'm going to go with Eye of Sauron. You can call it banana in a box. The next step is to type ngModel. That is the directive for two-way binding in Angular. Next, I'm going to set it equal to our message property. I'm going to save this HTML file. Let's run the app and see what happens. Well, we have an error. Can't bind to ngModel since it isn't a known property of input. What does this mean? Well, the ngModel is a directive that we have to actually import from the forms module. So let's go into our app.module.cs and we're going to import the forms module. Now, before we can use this module, we have to import it from the Angular form. So let's import forms module from Angular forms. I'm going to save the module. We can close this. Let's rerun the application. Now you can see that not only does the input automatically display the value of the message property, if I were to change this, it also updates the value of that property. This is a two-way binding, going from the component class to the UI and going from the UI back to the component class. And that's how easy it is to implement two-way binding in Angular. Well, you know what else is easy? Winning a one-year subscription to Infragistics Ultimate, just like Matero Barberi just did. Congratulations, my friend. You are the winner. I will be contacting you very shortly on how to claim your license. If you want a chance to enter for a one-year subscription to Infragistics Ultimate while at the same time learning to take your desktop skills to the web with Angular, subscribe to my channel, like this video, leave a comment below, and in the next video, I will announce another winner. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.